Photography opened my eyes to the beauty of the world. I have eyes that see beautiful things. I'm not sure, I don't think my eyes are particularly beautiful, but what they see, I think, is genuinely beautiful. I'm interested in observing real life. So a lot of photography is about representing a difference, it's not a reality, but a lot of photography is used to sell us things and to show us a superficial version of real life. I've been working as a photographer for approximately 15 years. I initially studied under a fantastic tutor called Mick Williamson, who at London Metropolitan University, who took me under his wing and he became a mentor to me. And he really helped, he recognised something in my photography very early on, and he helped me to develop my photography to bring out what I think are its strengths. All my pictures I hope are interesting. They're interesting at least to me, but some I guess have a more universal appeal. This is possibly one of my most celebrated images. Yes, this image was taken in 1993 in Bolivia, in La Paz, in the capital, during the elections there. And it has a real tension, I think, to the photograph, both compositionally, but also in terms of what's going on in the photograph. There was a real sense of tension around the whole city on this particular day. The city was covered in soldiers, it was very important in order to get certain papers into the government offices on time on that particular day, and these people are waiting to do that. And there's also a kind of compositional tension to the photograph, with this circle going through the image all the way up the stairs. And all the different characters within it, I think, have interest. There's a South American Humphrey Bogart. There's a traditional Bolivian woman. There's what could be a reporter, maybe working for a newspaper or a magazine. And then the soldier himself, framed beautifully by the light. There are disciplines within photography, but I think, for me, the most interesting photography is one that works outside the discipline. In a way, it's the one that doesn't fit. It's a type of photography that doesn't fit squarely within a genre. My favourite photographers have been one that have been working as photojournalists, but their pictures are more likely to be, I would describe, as art. I think a photographer should have an interest in people and in relationships and. A personality which wants to understand the world. I think photography is a fantastic tool for helping us to understand who we are, how we live, how we relate to each other, what we do to the planet. It documents every aspect of our lives, really. So I think to be inquisitive, to want to know, to want to find out, and also to want to record, ultimately. Mick Williamson, my first tutor, he was a major influence on my work, not in necessarily the style of photography, but in developing my fascination with light, my love of light, and also working in black and white as well, because he works in black and white. His photography is very different to mine. Also, through him, I went to see a photography show at the Royal Festival Hall in... not the Royal Festival, the Hayward Gallery, rather, in the Hayward Gallery, very early on in my studies, by a photographer called Joseph Kadelka, who's a member of Magnum. And that show had a major effect on me, and I was completely knocked out by the intensity of the images, by what he described, what he captured, and there was an integrity to the images, there was a truth that I'd been looking for, and he was just a tremendous photographer and major influence on my work. There's several other photographers. Alex Webb, another Magnum member, he works in colour, primarily in colour, and he works in very heavily saturated colours, and he is looking more again at the quality of the light and the atmosphere rather than the details of the photograph. So he's been a big influence. And Henri Cartier-Bresson, who is the photographer's most famous photographer. Not many photographers, not many people outside of photography have heard of him. If you want to be famous, don't be a photographer, which is, to me, one of the things that attracted to me about it. But Henri Cartier-Bresson, again, has created some fabulous images, some timeless images that live well beyond their years, because they have this truth and they have something we talked about earlier, which is a decisive moment, where he captures something and you know that there's a before and an after of that photograph. And so therefore they have a life beyond that moment, which I found particularly exciting. Decisive moment is a very important part of my work too. I think I like photographs, again, the best of my photographs, I think, have that aspect of knowing that there's a before and an after moment, that someone has either just left or just or is about to enter the photograph, and that there is that moment that's frozen in time, and the moment before it or the moment after it is not the right one. But to get that exact moment, that exact one that captures both all the elements of the frame in its correct composition, and add then that element of time, that element of movement possibly, and then you have really recorded something very special. Well, this is another of my favourite images. It was taken in Venezuela in 2000, and it was in the house of a jazz musician who'd moved there from Germany after meeting and falling in love with the woman who became his wife. They both moved out to Venezuela, and he set up what is now a thriving jazz community within this town, which is called Ciudad Bolivar. And I went to see him, to photograph him. And as we were wandering around the house, I entered the front room, and the light suddenly entered through the window, and his daughter sat on the hammock, and with all these fantastic photographs, collection of family and friends and other images on the wall behind, with all the jazz instruments laid below them. And suddenly the arms of the hammock became like angel's wings, and suddenly she was transformed from his daughter, from Millie's daughter, to an angel. And there was a real beauty of that moment, which I think is captured in this picture. I guess if I have a philosophy as such, my philosophy is to attempt to understand more about people, about how they live their lives, about why they make certain decisions, about relationships ultimately, I guess. I've always been interested in relationships, my own personal relationships, other people's relationships, our relationship to each other, our relationship to the government, to the planet, to nature. All those things, I think, are very important. So I guess I'm interested in understanding why we make the decisions we make, why we choose to live in a certain way. So yeah, I guess it's about knowledge, really, ultimately.